Encontré una forma de salir de aquí. Guatilla is a lie. El Guatilla está mintiendo. Pues un mentiroso. Flipa, colega. Mira, mira, mira. Puerta. Vale. Dice, ¿esto lo he construido yo? No puede ser que lo haya construido ella. Todo eso tiene que ver con esta gente que están controlando los sueños. What the... Hace 3 días.
Vic, stop that. It's not a toy. You could kill someone. Someone you don't want to kill.
Send for a healer, you cretins! My legs are broken!
What do we do with her?
I haven't decided yet. We have enough on Sister Alessandra to hold a summary court-martial and execute her. Or we send her to Sadia to stand trial. She'll face death. Or worse. A solitary life sentence in the black hole. To be honest, I think that decision should be yours.
Ooh.
Our people must know the truth. Alessandra needs to stand trial for what she's done in Sadia. She must stand trial, but we don't know what's happening in Sadia. Someone may want to protect her, and we can't bring her with us to Mercuria. She's murdered thousands. And she believes she's righteous. Nothing will be gained from sparing her life.
La idea de matarla no... Yo sé que... ojo por ojo y todo eso... Estoy de acuerdo. Pero... El tema de juzgarla es lo suyo. Pero si la
Our
mandamos a salir... Yo la dejaría aquí.
Trial. What if we leave her here?
Leave her? Do you think that's a good idea, Kian?
Her crimes are against magicals. Let them decide what to do with her.
Eso es.
I don't imagine they'll show her any mercy. Oh, very well, Kian. We'll leave Sister Alessandra in the hands of her prisoners.
Eso es.
May the goddess.
Que sean ellos los que decidan.
Let me go, you fools. You're doing the shadows work. Goddess. Help me. Oh, it hurts.
What now, Kian?
We go back and we end this. Can I count on your help?
You can. When I followed you here, I had no idea. I had my suspicions. I don't trust Vamon and Saya. They've been lying to us, and they're planning something. But I was blinded by faith and my trust in the Council. I followed you so that I could arrest you, kill you if necessary, to have my eyes opened this way. A veil's been lifted, all thanks to you. I failed you. I failed our nation. And I'm sorry for that, Kian. For distrusting you. I should have known better.
I'm disappointed in him. He should know me better than to think I would knowingly betray my people. But I won't confront him about it until after the war is won. Our friendship may never be the same. But we need to put this behind us and move on. He should have known better than to brand me a traitor. But I understand why he made that mistake.
Perdonar.
I gave you reason to doubt me.
I'm not so sure about that, Kian. I acted rashly and...
General. Harmy. I forgive you. There's one thing I must know. Who told you I'd gone to Guillen?
Eso es.
Mother Utana. God knows me how she knew. Well, she has her sources. She urged me to follow you.
Ya, tú sí, como él sabía
she
ella.
Wanted you to see this with your own eyes.
Perhaps so, but how would she know what I'd find here?
Eso es.
She trusted me.
Yes, although if she already knew the truth, why did she say nothing? It wouldn't have been better to keep me in Mercurio and arrest Vamon and Sire?
I'm sure she had her reasons, Harmy. Is your cloud ship ready to bring us back?
The fastest ship in the fleet. We'll be there in less than 3 days.
Enough time to lay plans along the way. I need your most trusted men to fight alongside the rebels, against Vamon's troops.
They will. There are fewer of us than there are of them, but we have the light on our side. We'll follow your command, Kian. To the first mountain, if it be so.
What will happen to the prisoners?
They'll be freed, fed, cared for. They'll need to stay here until the situation in Mercuria has been resolved. After that, we can provide them with passage to wherever they want to go. We owe them that, and much more.
Eso es.
We'll have to leave young Bip with his parents, or I'm sure he'll try to sneak on board our ship. Bip, time to go.
El profeta.
Everything's ready for the ceremony, Your Excellency. The engineers have informed me that the engine is ready. Whenever you wish to begin.
My men have been posted around the city, ready to handle any unrest. Though I don't expect any. This being Reap Moon's Eve, most of the peasants will be too drunk to pay attention.
Is there anything else you need, Prophet?
You've done all I've asked. With the general away, there will be fewer distractions to worry about. The Office of Scientific Progress has proven itself a loyal servant to the Goddess. The support in Sadir has been unwavering.
Es Palpatine, tío.
Pleased with your work.
Thank you, Prophet. We live to serve the Goddess.
Where is the first?
In her room, praying for the success of our mission. She did not want to overshadow this ceremony with her presence. Her humility makes her a worthy one of the six.
You deserve all the glory tonight, sister. You and the commander, of course. When I activate the engine, a new era will begin. We will shape this world according to the wishes of the goddess. Magic will finally be eradicated. The transition may cause fear and unrest for a time, but I trust you to handle this with authority and efficiency.
Of course.
I must prepare. When I am ready, I'll send word to you. You will have the privilege of telling the people of this city. They're witnessing the birth of a new.
Vaya tela, macho. Aquí hay mucho Darth Vader. Aquí hay mucho rollo Star Wars, eh.
Harmy has returned. With Kian. He's joined the resistance.
What? Who told you this?
They've been trying to recruit my men. Some have turned, though most have not.
Ya se ha enterado, tío.
You inform the prophet.
And have him cast us from the top of the tower. We'll handle this. The prophet will never know.
Mother Utana and the first. They can't know either. They might interfere.
You take care of them. I will take care of the resistance and Harmy. Once and for all. Soon it won't even matter. Tonight, once the engine is active.
Oh,
we take control, yes, I know. I just... We didn't need this. Not when we're so close, after all that we...
Don't worry yourself, sire. Proceed as planned.
Yes. Yes.
El profeta salía en el en Dreamfall, aparecía, y yo le puse el mote de Palpatine. Y bueno, aquí ya es medio Palpatine y medio Darth Vader.
Long ago, when I was a boy, exploring the mountains close to my village,
I met an old Dormari man, herding his stone goats. Our two people were officially at war, but there were still Dormari tribes near our village and some trade between humans and magicals. The old man spoke with kindness, fed me dried fruits and goat's milk, and told me I had magic in me, just like his grandchildren. When I returned home and told my mother, she commanded me to never speak a word of this to my father. And then she leaned in and whispered something in my ear I'll always remember. Magic, she said, is a part of everything. Magic is in the wind and rain, the stones and the ocean. It's in me, my mother said. And it's in you. Your heart, your mind, your blood. We've been at war with magic for most of my life, but I've never forgot my mother's whispered words. And I've always felt it in me, felt that magic's a part of me. For decades, I've fought it, denied it, rejected it. Tonight, that fight ends.
Anda, mira.
And another begins.
El que creaba la máquina.
This is no longer a war between humans and magicals. This is a battle for the very soul of our world. If you will have me, if you accept us, we stand with you all. We fight at your side. Tonight, we put aside our differences, our history, our grievances, and we stand united as one. Humans and magicals, Azadi and Northlanders, we are all Arcadians. Our eyes have been opened to the truth of what's being done to magicals. The Prophet has deceived the Azadi people. The engine is a weapon aimed at us all. We don't yet know what this ceremony will bring, but if we don't act tonight, in the face of death, we shall live to regret it tomorrow. General Hami will lead sorties against Vamon's men, force their surrender, and push through to the commander and Sister Saya. Those who refuse to lay down their arms, we fight. As hard as it will be to strike at your own brothers, there's no other choice. Your goal is to apprehend Saya and Vamon, alive if possible, dead if necessary. You'll take your commands from the general. Any misgivings you may have must be put to rest now. I trust Hami with my life. And tonight, so shall you. Anik will lead a team to Coldstone to free Ulvik and the imprisoned rebels, along with Benrime Salmin, who risked her life aiding the resistance.
Muy bien.
The engine must be destroyed. We don't know what it's truly for or how it works, but the Prophet means to reshape the world using its powers. This isn't magic. It's something darker than sorcery. Something older and infinitely more dangerous. Let's stop it. Let's stop them all from destroying our world, from destroying magic. Let's do this in the memory of our absent comrades. Liko, Bob who can see, there's been enough death. Come back alive. You've received your assignments. Prepare to move out. And when this night is over, let's all return here to watch the sun rise on a new Mercuria.
Flipante, macho, flipante.
You know what to do, Kian? Ferdows will shut down the engine from the control room near the green. In order to do that, he needs me inside the tower.
You'll go alone?
I've been inside before. It will be easier on my own. Anna and Enu will escort Ferdows and keep him safe.
I wish we could fight side by side tonight, but your task is more important and more perilous.
You'll have the resistance by your side.
I couldn't ask for better company. My men won't flinch from their duty. When they learned what was being done to the non-humans and what the camps were for, I wish there was time to spread the truth further. But instead, we're forced to fight our own. We can only hope that most choose to surrender rather than remain loyal to Vamon.
I'm sure they will.
once they find themselves facing you. Civil war is a terrible thing, Army. Most men shy from it. I don't envy you your task tonight.
We do what we must. Goddess protect you, Kian. If all goes well, we'll talk again soon.
We shall.
Bueno, jóvenes, flipante todo lo que está pasando en este, creo que, libro final. Uf. Madre mía. Es flipante. Os voy a ser sinceros, yo cuando estábamos con Zoe, yo quería haber cortado. Pero he continuado un poquito, he continuado un poquito. Me he picado y he seguido. Y con la tontería, pues casi una hora más. Pues nada, ya está. Otro bloque de partida súper guapo. Súper guapo que se va a quedar. Lo vamos a hacer guapo del todo. Leyendo los personajes que están desbloqueados. En este caso, a Naxxus. Cuando April Ryan llegó por primera vez a Mercuria, Naxxus era el embajador Benar ante el Consejo Airet y guardián de un pedazo del disco de piedra. Como todos los Benar, a Naxxus ve todos los tiempos a la vez, pero se eligió como embajador porque solo él de entre su pueblo, que está esto mal traducido, fue entrenado para centrarse en un momento en particular. Así podía hablar con la gente que fluye con el tiempo. Hace 10 años, cuando los Azadín invadieron Mercuria, Naxxus abandonó el norte. Esperaba reunirse con su pueblo y su familia, pero el destino tenía otros planes para Naxxus. Los ejércitos tirenos ya marchaban por las tierras más allá de las montañas frontera, y los Benar fueron forzados a huir. Cuando Naxxus llegó a la montaña, se encontró que el paso estaba imposibilitado y que su pueblo se había marchado. Desde entonces, Naxxus ha perdido gran parte de su habilidad para mantenerse anclado en el presente. Está debilitado y enfermo y aguarda a su pueblo y a su familia perdida. Se quedó allí con los Ular. Ha habido un momento que me ha venido ahí un flash en el que yo digo, el final de este juego sería puntazo si apareciera April transformada como dragón y los petara a todos. No sé por qué. Yo digo, esto sería un puntazo total ya. Pero no creo que se dé eso. El profeta. El profeta ha influido en el Consejo Azadil a 6 durante una década. Afirmando ser la voz de la diosa, sus ojos y oídos en la tierra, el profeta ordenó a los Azadí viajar a través del gran mar hasta las tierras del norte para ocupar Mercuria y comenzar la construcción de la enorme torre y la misteriosa máquina. El profeta ha hecho visitas regulares y normalmente no anunciadas tanto a la emisora en Mercuria como a las 6 en Sadir. Como administradora del proyecto Máquina, la hermana Saya ha descubierto de primera mano lo poderoso y manipulador que es el profeta. El Palpatine, que es el que aparecía en Dreamfall. Muy bien, jóvenes, muy bien. Pues pedazo de bloque de partidas que nos va a quedar. Hacía tiempo que no jugaba tanto. 2 horas y vamos, unas ganazas. Ya es que ya se está haciendo tarde, ya no, y mañana tengo que madrugar un montón. Así que no puedo continuar, pero sí, tengo ganas. Comentaba en el anterior bloque de partidas de que posiblemente este iba a ser el último. Pues no, puede ser que a lo mejor el siguiente sea el último. Tengo también mis dudas, porque acabamos de empezar ese libro número 5. Este capítulo sigue en movimiento, así que yo creo que a lo mejor nos queda un poco más. Y nada, se nos alarga la historia. O sea, no digo de alargue por el hecho de decir qué aburrimiento, sino justo al contrario, se nos alarga y va a llegar hasta más o menos los niveles de Longest Journey con 80 vídeos. Se va a quedar en unos yo creo superiores 50 vídeos como mínimo. De momento 50. Y 50 y tantos también. Más que decentes, ¿eh? Yo solamente espero que lo estéis disfrutando de verdad. Ha sido un bloque de partidas brutal. El anterior también me encantó. Este ha sido brutal. Este ha habido momentos en los que me ha tocado mucho la patata, sobre todo el tema de Cuervo, cuando he recordado a April, cuando Zoe ha desaparecido y él se ha quedado diciendo, me dejas aquí, me abandonas. ¡Wow! Macho, es que me ha tocado, es que no me lo esperaba y me ha hecho... Me he soltado la lagrimilla. Sí, ahora sí que no lo puedo evitar, tengo que decirlo. Me ha saltado la lagrimilla porque es que le tengo un cariño a Cuervo y con toda esta situación, ¡buah! Qué pena me ha dado. Pero fíjate, como se ha repuesto y ha dicho, voy con Kian y voy a echarle una mano. Ya, pues nada, por lo menos Cuervo sigue siendo importante. Y curioso, ¿eh? Porque Cuervo tiene un papel fundamental en esta historia. Por lo que nos ha dicho, es mágico. Y da la sensación de que es un personaje que antes tenía... Yo por un momento he pensado, ¿te apuestas a que es un dragón y que se ha reencarnado en Cuervo? ¿O que era un mágico o era alguien importante? Creo que es un dragón o lo que fuera. Y se ha reencarnado y está en esa situación. Y que luego después cuando finalice todo esto, saldrá su verdadera forma. Bueno, estos son puntazos, tíos, que no te los pueden imaginar. Y bueno, y por supuesto Zoe. No sabemos exactamente qué es lo que ha pasado con Lux. Parece que se haya fusionado, asimilado con ella. En fin. Hay muchas incógnitas, muchas dudas, muchas preguntas que esperamos que en los siguientes bloques de partidas los podamos responder. Pero esto lo que hace es que amemos todavía más esta saga y este Dreamfall Chapters sea cada vez más memorable. Yo no os envidio a aquellos que jugasteis este juego en el 2014-2015 cuando apareció. Y como era por capítulos, iban saliendo los capítulos cada X tiempo, no os envidio para nada, ¿eh? Pero para nada. Porque el hecho de que yo pueda jugarlas todos de un tirón es una bendición, ¿eh? Si tuviera que jugar los capítulos cada 6 meses, ¡buah! Menudo rollo. En fin, bueno, lo dicho. Ha sido un placer, jóvenes. Nos vemos aquí en vuestro canal Juegos Perdidos. Hasta más ver.